Jessica from Intellidance here. Today I have a little rhyme about a frog to teach you. Now, most of you probably have heard this rhyme either talking about Tiny Tim the frog or the turtle. In my version, we're going to talk about Tiny Tim the frog, but we're going to adapt the rhyme three different times and we're going to use the idea of size and vocal dynamics. So we're going to have Tiny Tim the little frog, Teeny Tim the smaller frog, and Great Big Tim the great big frog. And as you can see, as I'm changing the size of my body, I'm also changing the vocal quality of my voice. So we're gonna start and make our frog go ribbit, ribbit. Let's make him dance. I had a little frog. His name was Tiny Tim. I put him in the bathtub to see if he could swim. He drank up all the water, he ate up all the soap, and then he burped last night from a bubble in his throat. Burp. Oh dear, we say, excuse me. Can you make an even tinier frog? He's so small. Make your body as small as possible. And he goes, ribbit, ribbit. Let's make him go bounce, 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 bounce. I had a tiny frog. His name was Tiny Tim. I put him in the bathtub to see could swim. He drank up all the water, he ate up all the soap, and then he burped last night from a bubble in his throat. Burp. Oh dear, we say, excuse me. Can you stretch a great big frog body? I have a great big frog now. And he goes, ribbit, ribbit. I have a great big frog. His name is Great Big Tim. I put him in the bathtub to see if he could swim. He drank up all the water. He ate up all the soap and then he burped last night from a bubble in his throat. Burp. Oh dear, he says, excuse me. So as you can see, that's a really silly little rhyme, but the kids really get into it and it gives them a very clear idea of changing size in their body along with the sizes of the frog and engaging in different vocal play. I hope your preschoolers enjoy this song as much as I do, and we'll see you soon.